Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. Whether that's one of the best Beatles songs of all time or just a weird song about LSD is up for debate. But what is LSD and is it actually dangerous? Hey guys, Julia here for D News. When you hear LSD, you might think of a Beatles song or a little piece of white paper that'll take you on a trip, man. While both heralded as a mind-expanding wonder drug or derided as dangerous and triggering delusions, LSD holds some power in our collective imagination. But what is it? LSD is a derivative of ergot. If that's familiar to you, it's because ergot is a fungus that frequently grows on rye and wheat. And sometimes that's baked into bread that people eat, and some young girls start tripping on the fungus, and then suddenly the villagers decide to kill a whole bunch of people for being witches. Seriously, ergot probably caused the Salem witch trials. In small doses, ergot was used as medicine for centuries. It was used to aid childbirth, to quicken delivery, and stop bleeding afterwards. So naturally, a pharmaceutical company looked into its potential benefits in the early decades of the 20th century. One guy at the company, chemist Albert Hoffman, was tasked with isolating the compounds and trying to synthesize it by other means so that maybe it wouldn't kill you? In 1938, he tried a few variations, but not with much success. On a few animal experiments, however, he noticed that one variation, lysergic acid diethylamide 25, or LSD 25, had a strange effect on the mice. They acted excited for some reason. But still, the company didn't think much of the compound and mostly forgot about it. Hoffman, however, couldn't stop thinking about it and those excited animals. A few years later, he tried to recreate the compound, but one day while working on it, he felt a little strange. He went home and laid down, and well, he tripped the heck out. But he couldn't figure out what did it. He knew LSD could be poisonous, so he took extra precautions to avoid ingestion. So he concluded that he absorbed a tiny amount of LSD through his fingertips. Well, he made the compound and proceeded to experiment on himself for a while, and the rest is history. LSD became a centerpiece of the counterculture movement in the 1960s after the patents expired. Millions saw it as a way to expand their spiritual horizons. But soon there was a cultural and literal crackdown on any sort of drug, and LSD became illegal in 1968. Since then, it's been really difficult to study in a lab because of legal restrictions. I mean, it's hard to get funding for something that's still technically illegal. It's still classified by the Drug Enforcement Administration as a Schedule 1 drug, labeling it as one of the most dangerous drugs, with no currently accepted medical use and a high potential for abuse. But from early experiments and a few recent ones, we know some things about the drug. It works in a few ways. One study published in the journal Cell Press found that hallucinogens like LSD work on serotonin receptors in the brain called 5-HT2A receptors. While you might know serotonin as the feel-good drug, it actually has a number of different uses in the brain. Claire Stanford, a psychopharmacologist at University College London, thinks that serotonin helps keep a handle on perception and actually stops us from hallucinating. So by blocking the serotonin receptors in your brain with LSD, your brain just kind of loses its grip on perception. Or another idea, Andrew Sewell, a Yale psychiatrist who studies psychedelic drugs, thinks that LSD enhances some part of your perception, that such drugs lower activity in your thalamus. It sits at the center of your brain and filters your sensory information from all your nerves. Sewell thinks that by dampening down this filter, you become more aware of the information actually coming into your system. So sights and sounds become louder or brighter, and you might start seeing things you never noticed before. Or you might just start seeing things, period. But anyways, it's this mind-altering drug dangerous? Well, one study published in the journal Lancet found that it's actually one of the least harmful drugs, both to the user and to others. I mean, when people do take it, they tend to be overly cautious, like being aware that there's a time and a place for it, like festivals in the middle of a desert. Well, there's no link between the drug and mental illness, according to one study published in the journal Psychopharmacology. And in fact, it might be beneficial for those who suffer from depression. But okay, before this sounds like some kind of wonder drug, there are some downsides, like bad trips, or one common charge aimed at the drug is that will induce acid flashbacks. Or the idea that the drug changes a person's brain so much that days, months, or years later, you'll momentarily get the hallucinations associated with the drug, which in a recent case study published in the Israel Journal of Psychiatry led to one person developing Alice in Wonderland syndrome. No, he doesn't keep falling down rabbit holes, but he does keep seeing things and people as bigger or smaller than they really are. But on the other hand, one study published in the journal Drug and Alcohol Dependence concluded that such flashbacks, or hallucinogen persisting perception disorder, as it's formally called, is incredibly rare. So either way, it's clear more research is needed on this drug, and in the past 5 years, more research is being greenlit, so hopefully we'll have more to talk about in future D News episodes. So do you have any other pressing science questions? Let us know. You can tell us in the comments down below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.